Live, and I got the notification and jumped in, so I can see the stream. Hopefully everybody else feels like joining can too. If you are just joining us for the first time, this is Hellblade: Senua's Sacrifice. This is the third night, so this is about the last third of the game. We're going to be wrapping up tonight. This is set to auto difficulty. It levels up as, or it strengthens the difficulty as you do battle, and we have yet to die in combat. Did die yesterday falling off of a balance beam, which is kind of annoying. I haven't died in combat, so combat's actually really difficult at this point. I imagine there will be some dying tonight, but I said that last night too. It's always good to believe in yourself. So that's kind of what's going on. I'm playing on the computer using an Xbox controller. If you are joining us on YouTube, hello. Uh-oh. Let's see. Now, we are having a windstorm in San Antonio right now. If there is a problem where it starts getting a little too choppy, we will stop for the night and reschedule to another night to finish out. I'm hoping that doesn't happen, but I am seeing a little bit of stuttering on the stream. If you're joining us on YouTube, all three of the nights are being posted at one time on YouTube, so you can watch straight through. If you are starting out on this video, go back to the Rely on Horror main page and go to videos. You will see two more uploads that should be before this one that will have Hellblade: Senua's Sacrifice Part 1 and Part 2. And there's another stutter. I'm kind of worried about this. Hey. We can see, but we might have to stop. This just a second. I'm going to check again one more time and try restarting Twitch on my phone and see if it's a problem from my phone. If it's definitely a stream problem, I don't want to risk getting further into the game and to the next save point if we have to restart, because I will not be able to go back. Bear with me, we're going to run down for just a moment and see what kind of choppiness or lag we get.
Go away! I'm not listening! Go away. I'm not listening.
Okay, so I am still getting a lot of choppiness on my end. Hopefully that clears up as we go. It's not bad enough that I'm ready to call it just yet.
I will tell you of a great hero named Sigurd, son of Sigmund, no less. Born after his father's death, Sigurd is cared for by the dwarf, Reyn. But Reyn does not love the boy. Instead, he plans to use him for his own ends. You see, Reyn's father possessed a great treasure given to him by the gods. But Reyn's brother, Fafnir, killed his father and took the gold all for himself. Fafnir hid the treasure out on a heath and could not leave it. And from the evil in his heart, he turned into a dark creature. A dragon.
Something behind the door.
What is it?
She can feel it.
No.
Don't open the door.
No, go in. Don't open back. Don't.
What's in there?
Get back! A great beast guards Helheim. Garm is its name, and it knows you are here, Senua. It can smell your stink. What are you afraid of, Senua? How will you save Dillion if you are too much of a coward to step into the shadows?
They can't stop me.
Then do it! Stalking you from the shadows. Your sword is useless here.
Me, Senua.
It's so loud.
It's not her.
So full of hate.
It's a trap.
I just want to help them. Tell me what to do.
Your father wants them to go away. And he only hurts me to silence them.
But he's gone now.
But they always come back. He says I will die if I go with them. They say that I'm already dead.
No,
and they want me with them.
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't listen.
Do you
to them.
See them? Do you see their faces?
He's coming! Senua! Help me! Help! Get me out of here! Don't go!
Where has she gone? She's disappeared again.
She shouldn't be here. She escaped the darkness. She took her own life to escape it.
She can't remember when it started. When her mother lost her smile. Her eyes gazing past her towards a world she could not see. This is what happens if you reach for the underworld, he said. It was a lot to take in for a child. And the first time she felt the cold chill of fear. I don't talk much about her father, Sinbel. I suppose I just didn't want to risk upsetting her. But it doesn't matter now, does it?
Shh.
the sound design on this game. It's super creepy.
Stronger than you. Lighting the torch.
It's not gonna help her.
She's lighting the torch. That keeps you safe. To keep the darkness. Do you think you can keep away from the shadows if you light the torch? The darkness is safe. You're wrong. Burning. You're safe.
She hasn't.
She did it. She's done it.
Well done.
This place. It reminds her of the isolating, suffocating darkness that she lived through as a young girl. Imprisoned in her room at night. The faces in the dark, coming through the walls. She once thought everyone could see them. I mean, that's what children say all the time, isn't it? That there are monsters in the dark. By the time she realized that only she could see them, her father, Zinbel, could see the monster in her.
The beast has been here. Everywhere. It must be finished. She has to.
She'll have to go under.
She can't.
She has to.
No, she can't.
The torch will go out.
Don't let the torch go out.
She can't do it.
She can't do it.
The light's gone out. Run, run. Get through it as quick as you can. The panic is here.
What?
Rayan the Dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rayan would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Rayan reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Rayan.
The beast is crawling into your mind, searching for weakness. It found your mother, and used her to trap you in here.
Did you see her die? I don't remember. I was only 5. They told me she escaped the darkness. That she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here?
So. The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of all who owned it. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure.
Coming.
Run away from the beast! Run now!
What have you done?
No! No!
You've lost it! It's over!
The darkness.
Without his head, you will never bring his soul back. His fate is sealed. Now it can see you at your weakest. The time you suffered as a child at the hands of your father Zimno while you pined for Dillion. Do you remember the darkness, Senua? The beast is bringing it back.
Why did you leave me? This darkness, it's spreading. Father's keeping me away from the others. Away from Dillion. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here. I'm going to find Dillion.
Fuck.
Anticipate the moves.
Fuck me. That guy?
Surprise him!
Get out of the way!
Behind you!
Where the fuck is my... Didn't I have a torch? I forget to get the fucking green to begin with. My nemesis. The balance beam.
Why doesn't she learn? Until she learns. She doesn't understand.
Now the darkness has Dilly inside.
And it will take it and never give it back.
She can search and search, but she will never find it.
She's let the darkness in. It's the end.
Although Sigurd kills the dragon, Rian wants to keep Fafnir's gold all for himself. Rian also wants the strength and wisdom of the dragon, so he drinks its blood and asks Sigurd to roast Fafnir's heart for him. Sigurd does so, but when he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby.
Once she gets down there, she'll The darkness will take her like it took her mother. Deep and deeper. The beast knows. The beast knows exactly where she is.
She's falling for it.
She falls for it every time. Plays into his hands. The lights run out. She'll die.
So,
she can't.
She'll die.
She has to.
We are your guys.
She can't.
She's going to go through anyway.
The light will run out.
The darkness will spread.
And she'll die. What's she doing?
She's lighting.
She's making light. She's making a fire.
She's got light on her side.
She'll be safe. What's her plan? What's she thinking? Where's she going to get there?
The fucking bridge. Get up. Get. Fuck me. God damn it. And the rat's crawling further up your arm.
Sigurd's newfound power lets him hear the birds speak, and they say Sigurd should eat the heart himself. Rhian wants Fafnir's gold. Sigurd should kill Rhian before Rhian kills him. Sigurd should find Brynhild the Valkyrie, who sleeps an enchanted sleep. Sigurd heeds the bird's advice. He kills Rhian, eats Fafnir's roasted heart, and takes Fafnir's treasure. And he embarks on a new quest. To ride to Hinderfell and find Brynhild, the Valkyrie.
She's making a fire.
She's got light on the other side.
She'll be safe. What's she thinking? Where's she going to get there?
You killed her. You killed her.
Maybe this time we'll get it right. Maybe. Okay. There we go.
Where is she going? Faster, faster, keep going, keep going.
What is she doing?
Stop.
Flame in a world so black. The longer it burned, the more she convinced herself that there was nothing beyond its reach. How little separates us from what we fear.
Keep the torch alight.
What is she doing? Pick up. Sigurd learns that Brynhild had once disobeyed Odin, and so he had her punished, stuck her with a sleep thorn, and put her body within a rampart of burning shields. Only a man who knew no fear would ever reach her. But like me, Sigurd is fearless and passes through the flames, just as I did, and wakes the sleeping warrior girl. She teaches him the secret wisdom of runes, namely victory runes, ship runes, runes for persuasion, runes for truth, runes for healing and health, runes for perception and power. Like Sigurd, the greatest young warrior of the North, you must learn the secrets of the runes to fight amongst the gods in hell.
You killed us. You killed us.
I ain't killed shit lately.
Thank you.
must.
No, he isn't.
He's behind him.
Jesus Christ.
People think of evil as an unnatural, invisible force, and so invoke the gods for protection. But evil can come from the hand behind the gods. A familiar hand, cold and cruel. He tried to fix her with his rituals, kept her trapped in that hole.
She couldn't say which was worse. The darkness.
Or the monster that her father had become. She couldn't fight them both. And so she left. Headed for the one ray of light that shone down on her. If she had stayed, she wouldn't have survived. Maybe Delian would still be alive.
I'm so sorry, my love.
She will save his soul. Even if this time she can't save her own.
Sorry for the sniffles. I have really bad allergies, and they are made worse by that.
Forgive me, Senua.
Worse. Not worst. by the fact that the wind is gone.
Trust me anymore.
Shadow, listen.
But believe this. It was my mission to make you hate. To hate the darkness with a passion so great it would focus your mind on this quest. This time, I've wanted to protect you from the truth that would have destroyed you a long time ago. But you have conquered your darkness at every turn. You deserve to see behind the layer of darkness.
And take me to the mountain to trust you, as deep as we can go.
I won't stand in your way.
She has to trust him.
You will not survive what is in there.
I know. What else can she do? Nothing. She doesn't want to tell us.
She has nothing. He has nothing.
She's come this far. She wants to go for
it.
This
is it.
She wants to save Dillian's soul. She must listen to the shadow. Going, son. It's too dangerous to listen. I know.
Look!
What?
Hal escaped.
Mother, I won't let the darkness trick me again. I know you're safe with the gods. I can feel Hela's gaze searching for secrets inside of me. Secrets that even I can't see. I'm not here to fight my past. I'm here for Dillian. I will fulfill my vow, whatever the cost.
Destiny of the gods. First, there will be a terrible winter, 3 years long. Then, mankind will turn on itself. Brothers will fight each other to the death, and people will forget what they owe their kindred. Times will be hard. Crimes will be great. It will be an age of axes and swords. The wind will blow through abandoned halls. Wolves will walk where children played. The world will fall into ruin.
At all. Fine, we fix the bridge, then we battle. Whatever, do it their way first. Part of it. Now battle. Battle bots? Oh man. That's not how that works, actually.
Oh,
everybody's behind me, 100% of the time, apparently.
Watch out!
It's about to be, though.
Quick, behind you.
Fuck. Why can't... Blocking you behind fucking shit you cannot see is bullshit.
She won't make it. She'll never finish it. It's nearly over.
Finish it.
Man!
Behind you.
Everything's behind me. There's fucking monsters behind me. There's fucking walls behind me. There's apparently every fucking thing in the world is behind me all the goddamn time. There's a 2-square-inch fucking area to fight in. Can I please, for 5 fucking seconds, maybe... Everything is fucking behind me. I can't move. I can't dodge.
Behind you.
Why is she running in that direction? That's not even the fucking button I pushed. God damn it.
The mirror. Focus. It's building. It's building. She's hurt. Watch out. Focus now. Don't give up.
Fuck. 872 fucking enemies in the same goddamn 4-inch space. It'll be fun.
It's not
sell you a fucking game made out of that shit. They Hellblade, they said. It'll be fun, they said. Fuck you, asshole!
You're close. Hurt this blood.
No shit. I'm fucking sick of your goddamn ass!
Yes, sir.
Get the fuck up.
She can still
do it. I'm tired of his ass too. Fucking sick of all you assholes.
She's injured. Behind you. It's not over.
And get the fuck up off of the goddamn ground. Fucking tired of you bitches. Real fucking tired.
She's injured.
It's about to be, because apparently we can't fucking load up anything other than bullshit.
She's injured. She can still do it.
Come on, bitch.
Finish this. End it now.
Fuck the fuck out of you. Apparently people who play games and do not get angry at them. I don't know these people.
She could give her own
soul. No. Literally don't think I know even one. Maybe Rourke.
But it's all she has to give. She has a warrior soul. What more could she give? A cursed soul. Of course she is.
She can say it.
broken. She has to fix it.
It's too dangerous.
She's done it before.
You have to fight her.
Be careful.
The final battle.
Get me soul back.
It's the final task.
Yes, it is.
This isn't just a broken bridge, is it? Mother, you showed me how to see further. To see the hidden wonders in our world and explore new paths into the unknown. To lead so that others may follow, or to warn so that they may avoid. That is our gift and our duty. I'm not going to look away in fear anymore.
The Northmen say the gods will fight their last battle at Ragnarok. Their watchmen will blow the horn that can be heard through the whole world. And Odin will speak with the severed head of Mimir, which gives him good counsel. The land of the giants will thunder with the sound of their army on the move. The gods will assemble. The dwarves will leave their stones. The frost giants will come from the east. The Midgard serpent will churn up the waves. Eagles will scream and tear at the corpses with their yellow beaks. The ship of the dead will set sail.
Now for those watching who might think that I like hate the game or the developers, this is actually a really well done game. I love it. I've played 4 times. Well, it's not that I hate the game. It, like every game, has a couple of things that really piss me off. Very specifically, I dislike when I have to deal with, if I'm trying to dodge around something or move around something, and Witcher, which I have played several hundred hours of, has the same problem. Don't make me clip into things or run into things or be blocked by things that you have decided to make invisible so that it doesn't block my vision. I mean, on the one hand, yeah, it makes for a very pretty game. It doesn't block my vision. On the other hand, I need to be able to use my vision.
She can do it.
She can.
Otherwise, I'm just like, what in the fuck am I running into, and how do I get around it?
She's so special.
They're so special.
She must see. She has the sight.
Where's my other?
She can see their secrets.
Where is my up? I need to go much further up than that.
There's an illusion. She's found a way. There's a way. She can see. She must align herself. She can do it.
There's the
door.
Trying to see. Ah, there we go.
The Northmen say that at Ragnarok, the gods will face a ship full of their foes, which Loki has steered to Asgard. It carries the fire giants, the wolf that will eat the sun, and all kinds of dark creatures. Surt will join them with his sword of fire. The cliffs will crash, Trolls will walk the land. Men will tread the road to hell, and the heavens will split open.
Before we go in here, I am going to take a 60-second break, so I'll be right back. Over. So we can go ahead and leave. There's another battle coming up. Well, I want to take that break then. That's gonna be a battle. What there?
The Northmen said each god will do battle. Ragnarok. Odin will fight the monstrous wolf and be killed, but his son will avenge him and plunge his sword into the heart of the beast. Freyr will face Surt, but he had given his sword away for love, and without it, he cannot defend himself against the flames. Thor will smite the Midgard serpent to no avail. The sun will grow black, the earth will sink into the sea, the stars will disappear, fire and water will meet, steam will shoot up, flames will play against the sky, the heavens and earth and all the world will be burned, all the gods will be dead, and the warriors of Valhalla and the people everywhere. Senua, prepare yourself for Ragnarok. Or it is nigh.
Oh god, it's this asshole.
Oh.
two of these. I'm trying. This auto-targeting thing has got to fucking go, though. Better. There's people up here. We can go down here and do more battles and go through that door and do more battles. We have now gotten to the slightly unbalanced part of Hellblade. The beginning is a very good balance of exploring and storyline and fighting, and the end is just like, fight. Now you can fight some more. Wouldn't it be fun if we could fight? Go backwards like I'm telling you to. That is not who I meant to fucking hit at all! What the fuck? That was... This is entirely the game's fault, though. Like, very specifically, you can't fucking auto-target when there's gonna be, like, certain characters you have to do certain things to.
Don't
pushed evade. Fuck me. That is not the fucking enemy I'm going for. Seriously? Like, he gets to fucking pirouette? This guy's the size of a fucking boat and he gets to do a pirouette?
She's hurt. She won't make it.
Fucking focus, and I would love to see what's behind me. Unfortunately, I'm targeting the wrong goddamn thing. Fuck you. Fuck the fuck out of you. Fuck no, I'm not gonna invade that fucker. Stupid ass. Get up. Start over. 782 fucking enemies. We're gonna pick which one you target. It'll be the one at the other side of the group. Just fucking die a whole bunch, let it get all the way up my arm and go back to using my legs. Really? Really? Now we're gonna fucking... Okay, is there a way to fucking change what it's targeting? Why is there no combat control that lets me go... No, I don't want you to pick what I'm targeting. I am perfectly capable as a fucking adult. Like... No, it picks what I'm targeting. Fucking over your shit, dude! Fuck you. Fuck you! Fuck.
It's not over.
Fucking should be. I mean, I'm over it, so... Can it be over? That was obviously not who I'm trying to kick. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck this shit. I mean, that's one way to get to the other side of them. Again, not who I'm trying to kick. You and your stupid fucking shit.
It's nearly over. Finish it.
Fuck your stupid ass too.
Ended it.
That is obviously not who I'm fucking targeting. Holy shit. Make sure he's in the center of my fucking camera here. Get up! There's gonna be like five fucking more, and you're not gonna be able to pick which one to target. It'll be fun. Super duper fun. Up the fuck out of you guys! Never noticed how much that particular mechanic pisses me off until now.
Wait. What? What happens when she dies? What happens to us? What happens to us?
We die too.
Do we die too?
We die too.
I don't want to die.
We'll all die someday.
I don't want to die.
And when everyone's gone, even the gods will die.
I don't want to die.
We don't want to die.
Stop.
I don't want to die.
Senua,
stop. Stand up.
Why would she start to die? She won't stop. 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 Stop.
I'm sorry. I didn't ask you to be a part of me. If you don't want to die with me, then leave me alone.
Stop.
I don't want to die. Please stop. Please stop.
Please stop.
Please stop. Please stop.
Please stop.
I really hope they patch in a way to, like...
Stop. You'll never come back if you go there.
There is nothing to go back to.
Turn off the auto-targeting.
Don't abandon me!
Everyone suffers. They were right about me.
Listen to me, not them.
They are afraid.
like children scared of the dark.
So was I.
They made up monsters to fill the void. That doesn't make them real.
They made them real.
No!
No!
Follow your soul and let go of the Senua of old. For there lies your weakness, and the darkness will find it.
It's not like the old stories, is it? The noble warrior facing evil in search of victory and honor. Clear dividing lines. No. Oh, this place is not quite like that. It's as if it knows that true torment lies within. Memories you cannot defeat. Cannot escape. This is her hell.
Nothing to fear anymore. The gods have saved your mother. Through my hands.
You killed her.
It is the will of the gods.
Fuck the gods! You did this to her! Why?
This is what happens when you listen to the voices of the underworld. They crawl into your soul and rot you from the inside. Defy the gods like your mother, and the darkness will come for you too.
These are the exact moments the backhand was made for.
Madness. I was just a child. You created this darkness. You created this darkness so you could hide behind it.
Only suffering brings salvation. It is the way of the gods.
It was all a lie. You are a lie! She didn't defy the gods. She defied you. And so you killed her.
You didn't pray to the gods. You prayed to mother, who was too weak to fight the darkness and abandoned you.
You tortured her! You killed her!
Those rituals, the years of isolation, the pain that still haunts you. It was the only way to fight the curse within you.
You're a liar.
The darkness is inside you, let me destroy you.
You're a liar!
No, Senua. The darkness is here. You can't wish it away. And it will watch as you draw the last dying gasp.
I won't let you kill me!
The
plague of darkness, the butchering of the nearby animals, men. You saw it yourself.
You told everyone I was cursed. They believed you. I believed you.
Tell me, Senua, where is Hylian's soul if the darkness is alive? How will you save them?
He's here. I know he's here. Dillian, I know you're here. Hold on. I'll find you.
Together. Thank you.
You're trying to trick me again with your lies. I know he's here. You took him from me. You have him.
Dillian's gone. Dillian is dead. Let him go.
Behind you.
Or what?
Cavils.
What can he do to me that you haven't already?
You betrayed your own father.
Fight me.
You betrayed.
Come on.
In search of Dillian.
Watch out.
In search of love. Look where that's got you. Let go of your
Watch
battle.
Out.
Let go of redemption. Let go of Dillian. Don't let your darkness hurt anyone else.
That was not who I was targeting at all. Jesus fucking Christ!
Battle. Let go of Dillian. You're killing yourself.
I'm aware. Hey guys! Yeah, no. I know I have to die. I just. Can make that battle last so much longer when it's not on auto or. Hard. Thank you. I don't know how we're not a Twitch affiliate yet. That would be a question for CJ. I do hate the, like, until you get it on a hard or auto up to hard difficulty, you can't really tell that it's targeting you to the wrong person because you can kill them fast enough that it isn't really an issue. But that targeting the guy at the back of the damn group is really awful. CJ pressed the button. You should turn the button red, then he'll press it. Everybody presses a red button. Harass him on Facebook. That's a good way to do it. Or harass him on Twitter.
You're alive.
Did you respond to all the harassment?
But you never took him from me, did you? And I can't save Diane.
Oh, I love this ending.
To confuse me and deceive me. But I know it's him.
I know you have him!
Guys, he can't be dead. He's been breathing in his little burlap sack this whole time. Ella might want to see to that head injury. Dillian.
But if you won't, you will have to kill me because I've got nothing left. No fear, no hate.
I see your comment there, Rolly.
You will have no power over me.
Yes, you did make me laugh at an inappropriate moment in the game.
I learned the hard way to not be afraid of death, Senna. Because a life without loss is one without love. You turn your back on death, and all you can see is the shadow that it casts. The longer you hide from it, the longer the shadow grows until all you can see is darkness. When our time comes, you must look death in the eye and embrace it as a friend. Only then can we let go of our fear. And emerge from our darkness.
Thank you.
Never forget what it is like to see the world as a child, Senua. Every autumn leaf is like a work of art. Every rolling cloud a moving picture. Every day, a new story. We too emerge from this magic, like a wave from the ocean, only to return to the sea. Even in darkness, the wonder and the beauty of this world never leaves us. It is always there, waiting to be seen again. Further than this.
Follow us. We have another story to tell.
My friend, go with her. This now will be your story to witness.
No, you are not the only one. That, to me, that is a, like, dead out. We have a sequel already planned. By the way, for anyone who wants to know before, like, waiting until the end of credits what this song is, this is VNV Nation's Illusion. You should listen to it. And everything else they've recorded. In this game, Melina Jurgens, I think is how you pronounce it, is the actress. And she's won 3 awards now for this game, I believe. And it deserves every award it's gotten. It is fun to play. It's a lot more fun on, like, normal difficulty, like a set difficulty. I'm fairly certain there's nobody who actually enjoys playing games on hard difficulty. I think that's just something you do to, like, say you did it. Yeah, she's not actually an actress, which is cool. I feel like there's several really good characters in game history that were played by people who were not actors or actresses before they played that character, and it turned out fantastic. And if you buy the game, there is a section. I'm not going to show it on YouTube because you can go and find it on the Ninja Theory YouTube. But there is a video that goes into the backstory of why they made this game. And like I said, they go into how the seed of the idea was because of a goddess named Senua that was found in the Celtic area, so Ireland, in like 2007 and 2008. I really like the music they chose for this. And people who are watching this on YouTube tomorrow or later, you won't be able to see the comments that I can see right now and that we can see in chat, but we have Raleigh here actually talking about Melina, and apparently she is Ninja Theory's video editor. She made all of the making of videos, and there's a lot of dev diaries. I haven't seen all of them. I've seen the one that they put into the beginning of the game. Like, if you go back and it says, hey, wait until you finish the game to watch this. Went back and watched that when I finished it for the first time. So I'll have to go check out the other ones that they've got. I would imagine they're all, like, either on their YouTube or on their website. I actually, after finishing this game, added this song to a playlist.
Please don't go. I want you to stay.
And Raleigh's saying that you should watch their Accolades trailer.
Please don't.
And it is Accolades. It's apparently a really cool one.
The world is just illusion.
Trying to change you. Please don't go. I want you to stay. I'm begging you, please. Please don't leave here.
I don't want you to change. For all the hurt that you feel.
This world is just illusion. Trying to change you. Okay, the Accolades trailer is apparently a collection of what people said about how the game affected them, which is really cool. Especially since this game did employ actual people who have either dealt with mental illness or who work in psychiatry. So it really did take all of the appropriate steps to make sure that it was respectful and true. And if you look right here, you will see, if you would like to find out more about psychosis and mental health difficulties, visit hellbladehelp.info. That site will actually lead you to actual help. So if you find that you feel really bad after this video, especially if you've suffered with mental health issues in the past, please go there and find resources to help you and reach out. I see our Nightbot caught wrong. Alright, well, that was the end of Hellblade. I hope everybody enjoyed this 3 nights of 3-hour streams. Between 2 and 3 hours. I'm not sure what we're going to play next week, but I have marked out Wednesday and Thursday night, so it will probably be another whole game. A shorter one than this, but a whole game. You made a clip of me singing. I'm gonna regret that. Like I said, I'm not sure what we're gonna be playing next week, but you can check out my stream, which happens on Wednesday nights, 7 p.m. Central Standard Time in the USA. I usually play indies. Hellblade is an indie, so it counts. A very good one, but it is an indie. CJ plays on Friday nights, so he will be on tomorrow night if he is feeling better. I know he's sick today. And I can't quite remember when Rourke plays, but I think it might be Saturdays. Other than that, you can check out our website at relyonhorror.com. We have a Facebook, we have an Instagram, we are all on Twitter. If you go to relyonhorror.com/staff, you should be able to find all of the writers' tags so that you can come and annoy us on Twitter. Or, you know, let us know about articles, news, what you thought. I am going to be at PAX South tomorrow and Saturday. There is an article on the website that says, hey, give us your questions for our hangout that's happening this weekend on Saturday. And if you have any questions for developers that are going to be at PAX South, I would be happy to go track them down and attempt to get those questions answered. If I can't, I am sorry. As for the hangout, that is going to be at 7 Central, I believe. No, it's going to be at 7 Eastern. It's a monthly hangout that we have that is hosted by our lovely Patreon supporters. We are patreon.com/relyonhorror. We are also on Twitch, twitch.com/relyonhorrortv. Our Patreon backers support a minimum staff a minimum pay for all of our staff once we get to a certain point. Right now we have a pay per article. We'd like to get to a minimum pay per staff member. So backing us on Patreon gets us more towards that. We do have ads on the site, but if you are a Patreon backer, you don't see those ads. It is a completely ad-free experience. There are other perks besides joining us on the Hangout Live. We do require pants for that. You can get all of our Mystery Science Theater 3000 style movie commentary. So if you like hearing what people have to say about movies, especially if you've already seen them, we have 13 of those. We're about to record our 14th, which I believe is going to be Silent Hill, the first movie. Once a month we put one out. It's just our thoughts on the movie as it's rolling. You can download every one of those that we have already recorded and all of them in the future as long as you are a Patreon backer. And that's for as little as $1 a month. So please consider backing us. Check out the Patreon to see what else we offer because I'm not really sure I've covered everything. Other than that, I guess I will see you guys next Wednesday, and actually I will see everybody who can tune in on Saturday night with our chat. We will be streaming it here on YouTube and on Facebook. So thanks again for joining us, and thanks to Raleigh for sitting with me through this.